I want to welcome you all once again to another of my tutorials. I'm about to cut the upper part for the dress which I want to make. So what we are going to do, I want to show you guys whenever you want to cut your fabric, what you need to do first before cutting your fabric. You need to cross check your fabric, because like this one I have now, it has pattern. You can see the what I have here. You can see the image here is facing up, so you need to make your image also to face up. You should not face upside down. Then what you need to take note of is your written word. So know your back and your front of your fabric. Like what I have here now, this is my front and this is my back because of the written words on it. If you cross check now, you can see the guarantee. Guaranteed that this written here is completely spelled. And if you turn it like this now, you will see you don't even know how to pronounce it. Look, you don't even know how to pronounce it, but once you turn it like this, it's completely spelled. So this side that is completely spelled is your main fabric, your right side of your fabric. So what you are going to do now, and another way where they put this label is the main side of your fabric. What you are going to do is to arrange it, because this takes a lot of material. So let me go ahead to crochet from this side. If I will have any better option for what I want to place at the up. So this is what I want to show you. You can see what is the name of this animal? Don't worry. Once I remember the name, I will tell you. Let's continue with our work. So even here, what I have to want to take my material or so you have to be sure of what you are working with. What I want to sew now. The material will be enough even if I decide to put this animal at the front. But if what you are making, you are not sure if your fabric will be enough, please don't try doing this. You can go ahead to cut so that you don't get short of fabric. Okay, it can still work like this. It can still work like this for me. So let me go ahead and bring my measurements book, because I forgot it. Okay, so to get my front measurement, I just remembered the name of the animal, and it is peacock. So your peacock needs to face up and not upside down. You need to face up like this. So your measurement, what you are going to do is to get your bust measurement, which is your biggest part of your measure of your body for the upper part, your bust, divided by 4 plus 4 inches. So what I have is 41 divided by 4 gives me 10.2 plus 4 inches. Let me make it 10.5. 1, 2, 3, 4. I have 14.5. So that is what I'm going to cut out for my front. 14.5 will be my full measurement for my width. 14.5. As I told you, this will waste your fabric because of the pattern on it. The peacock needs to be at the top. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is to get my peacock to be at the upper part. You can see the head of the peacock. And this is our measurement for the front bust measurement plus 4 inches. So what you need to do now is, I want to make the peacock to sit at the top. So I'm going to rule a straight line just like this. So what I want to make now is an off shoulder. Since I have a straight line, make sure your line is straight so you don't get a bent line when taking your measurements. Both your vertical and your horizontal must be straight. So what I'm going to do is to take away 4 inches up, because it is an off shoulder, and my full length of my of my half length rather is 17 inches plus 1 inch for your sewing allowance makes it 18. So come ahead here to take away the 4 again and bring out my 18 inches which I have because it is an off shoulder. So you are going to take away 4 inches at the top. Go ahead to move your line like this. Make sure it is straight. So when you are done doing that, all you need to do now is to cut it out. I will come back and list everything for you. But let me give you how to cut yours. As I told you, it is on fold. We are marking on the wrong side of the fabric. I showed you how to get your wrong part of your fabric. So this is what we are marking on, the wrong part of our fabric. So the back does not matter. You can go ahead to put any design you want for the back, any pattern you want to be at the back. This my paper is intruding. I will still take it off later. So for your back, to get your own back measurement is to divide your bust measurement plus 6. 2 inches that added is for the zipper allowance. You know the back is going to have zip. So your bust measurement plus 6 for the back. So all I'm going to do now is to place my front on the back, then include 2 inches. That will make me know that it is 6. You know what I have was plus 4 for the front. So if I plus another 2 for the back, it has added my zipper allowance. So that is all I'm going to do now. Then I'm going to cut out. So you can see this is 2 inches which I have here. 2 inches here. Not to worry, next time I will try my best to use pattern first before placing it on the fabric, in case for beginners that are scared of cutting on the fabric. So like I told you, you can see, so this is my zipper allowance at the back which I have here now. So I'll go ahead to work on the front first before doing for the back. So once you have your fabric like this, as I told you, this is the back. This is the wrong side of the fabric which you are going to mark. So what you will do is to get your 4 inches up away from your for your off shoulder, throw it away because it is an off shoulder, it will not sit at the shoulder. So what you need to get now is your shoulder to bust measurement. My shoulder to bust measurement is 11.5. So 11.5, that is what I am going to put here for my shoulder measurement. 11.5 is what I'm going to take here. Then my under bust measurement is 15. I'm going to plus 1 inch for sewing allowance, make it 15.5. So I come back here again to take my 11.5, my exact bust measurement. There is no added allowance at this bust, but your under bust measurement, you are going to add extra 1/2 inch for sewing allowance. Remember, so my bust measurement is 14.5, which I took there. My under bust measurement is 15. I added 1/2 inch for sewing allowance. That is what I got at my lower part for the under bust, plus 1/2 inch for sewing allowance. So all you need to do now is to get your nipple to nipple measurement. And my nipple to nipple measurement, I have a video on how to divide your nipple to nipple measurement. My nipple to nipple measurement is 4, is 8. Since it is 8, I'm going to plus 1/2 inch for sewing allowance, because after sewing that 1/2 inch, it will come back to 8. So I'm going to make it 4.5. So 4.5, you are going to take 4.5 down, or 4.5 from this part downward. You're going to take 4.5 and rule your straight line 4.5. I want to make sure it is easy for you to understand on how to go about this your cutting. So 4.5, which I have here now. So this is my center front and this is my side front. So let me go ahead to list everything out to bring out all your measurement and calculations. So after you have gotten your measurements like this, what you need to do for this center front is to come in by 1 inch. Then at your side front, you come in by 1.5. This measurement is for this kind of bust of 40, okay, let me say 39, 40, 41, 42. You can use this measurement for it. So I just want to go straight to the point. When I will give you a list on how to get your bigger bust later. So do the same thing, take your 1 inch here for the center front and come here by 1.5 for the under bust. So what you will do next is to get your, from your nipple point, you come down by 0.7, then you go up again by 0.7 to get your bust shape. So after you have come up by 0.7, come down by 0.7, what you are going to do at this upper part is to come out by 2 inches, come out by 2 inches for this bust. I don't want to go to dive into another one so you don't get confused. So for this bust, so after you have done with this, what you are going to do next is this your 0.7 inches which we have here. You are going to connect it down here, then straight down here, because what we have here is the same 1 inch which we took out. That is what we have here. So let me connect it down. So from here to here is the 1 inch we took out, and from here to here is the 1.5 inch which we took out. So what I'm going to do now is to connect the points, connect it from your 0.7, connect it like this down, like this, from your 0.7 point. That is where you connect it. And as this your bust point now, from this same 0.7, you are going to connect a curve like this. Hope you can see what I'm doing. I'm going to connect your curve like this. From this your 0.7, make sure it is not straight, it is circular. If you have your French curve, you can go ahead to place it from this 0.7. Sorry, I have gone far before I realized that I have been talking to myself all this while because my camera stopped filming. I have even gone ahead to cut before realizing, after looking at my camera, it is not showing anything. So I will go ahead to explain everything to you, or should I clean them off so you can understand? Okay, let me go ahead to clean them off. Okay, so where was I? I believe I stopped at this bringing out connecting your bust or connecting your darts together at this point now. So for this now, I told you, you come front by 2 inches. So when you are done connecting it from this your 0.7 inches down to this your point here, down to this 1 inch which I gave here, from the same 0.7 you connect it down to this position here, from the same 0.7 which I took at this upper part, I am going to connect from these 2 points down to that same 0.7. so that is what I am going to do. As I say, if you have your French curve, it will be easier for you. Don't worry, I will soon get my own French curve. We are progressing bit by bit. I will soon get my own French curve, don't worry. So that it will be easier for you to do. But for those that do not also have French curves, you can cope with this. You can follow suit. So after I have gotten all my connections, I want to show you how to get your body's measurements before cutting out. So we go over to our shoulder. My shoulder is 15 divided by 2, gives me 7.5. So this is my 7.5 which I have here now. 7.5 which I have here, plus these 2 inches for my darts which I'm going to take out, plus these 2 inches at this front here now, which I added here, these 2 inches which I'm going to cut out, I bring it out here. Then I'm going to plus 1 inch for my sewing allowance, because after cutting out this, when sewing, we are still going to take 1/2 inch from this side and 1/2 inch from this side, makes it 1 inch. So I have put that 1 inch back there. So after putting your 1 inch there, now you come over to your bust. My bust is 41 divided by 4, gives me 10.2. So 10.2 which I have here now, plus 1 inch for this sewing part here, because I'm going to take 1/2 inch here, 1/2 inch here, the same thing at the front. So I'm going to put that 1 inch here. So after putting your 1 inch, you go ahead to put your 2 inches for your sewing allowance, 2 inches for your sewing allowance. Then come over to your waistline here. Your waistline, my waistline is 35 divided by 4, gives me 8.7. So my 8.7, that is what I have here now, 8.7 which I have here now, plus my 2.5 inches which I'm going to cut out, but this is my dart, I'm going to cut them out, 2.5 inches. I bring that 2.5 inches back here, plus my 1 inches, plus my 1 inch, sorry, when sewing, 1 inch, 1/2 inch here, 1/2 inch here, bring back that 1 inch here. Then put your 2 inches for your sewing allowance which we have there. So all you need to do now is to connect this together, connect this together like this, and connect this one down. So to get your armhole measurements, your armhole measurement divided by 2, mine gives me 9. This is my armhole measurement divided by 2, gives me 9 here. So all I have to do now is to connect from this point now down to my sewing allowance which I have for the bust, bring it out. So after you are done doing that connection, all you need to do now is I'm going to cut my front after sewing. The mark you saw here when before I clean off, I want to show you on how to get your curve if you want to cut it before sewing. Me, I'm going to cut it after sewing. So I have to get your connections now. Since this is your underbust, all this part, when sewing this part, it will be straight, but your connection comes from here. All you need to do now is to get from this your distance now, from your waist. Okay, let me show you something again. From your half length now, it depends on how many you want your bust, how many you want the depth of your neck to show on your client. It is better you take their measurement. So for mine, I want it to be at 7. So at this 7 now, you just have to roll it, just have to take it off in a slanted form, like a shape that you want to link to this end here. Just connect it like that. So me, what I have here between here to this up, this does not, it's not necessarily needed, but what I have here is 1.7 inches which I have here. This one does not necessarily matters. So what I have here now is to get my point between this, from starting from your underbust, please, starting from your underbust, then connect to get your point here. So me, what I have here now, you can see my line here. What I have here now is 10 inches which I have for my calculation between this underbust to this point. That is 10 inches. So I'm still going to find the same 10 inches from this part here now. Find the same 10 inches from this part. 10 inches. That is what we are looking for. We are doing 10 inches. This is what we have here now. 10 inches. So this 10 inches now, you connect it down to your shoulder. So you can see, connect it, because when sewing, after sewing, everything will lap equal. So if I miss your 10 inches and I connect it down, so what I do now is to go ahead and cut it out. Okay, so this is it. After cutting now, this is it. I will still cut this out later for it to be guaranteed that it will work out after doing that. So let's go straight to our back first before we go back over to our front. So this is our peacock. I told you it should sit up. You can see my peacock. You can see the head is sitting at the front. Why I left a lot of space for the head to show. So you can see our peacock is sitting right in front of the chest. So go ahead to straighten. You know there is a paper inside there, so you need to take off your own. So what you need to do now is to come in by 2 inches for our zipper allowance. 2 inches for our zipper allowance. Connect it down. It is very, 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 very easy to make. So you can see, place your front like this. You can go as well to take out your measurements from your waist. This is our waist, which we have here, our waist. Our busts, waist and our busts. So go ahead and place your front, your side front on it like this. What you need to do now is to take 0.5 inch in from this part, then this part also coming by 0.5 inch. You can as well cut it equal, it will still come out, but I prefer using 0.5 inch. So I will advise you also use 0.5 inch. So 0.5 inch in this world, like 0.5 inch this world in 0.5 inch. So what you do now is to get your mark here, at least your side front, get your mark, just get your mark there. Once you have gotten your mark there, you connect your darts together. You connect your darts together, just like this. Connect your darts together. You can see, very easy. The back is the easiest thing to make so far. Even when it comes to men, the back is the easiest thing to make, but the front, you have to calculate, do a lot of calculation. So once you are done with that, that is that. So you go ahead to cut it out. As I have done for my front, I cut it out. I need to stop here. If you want to cut it out, don't call me. Because for beginners, for me, I can go ahead to cut it out and know where to place for where. But for beginners, in case you don't know how to go about this, if you cut it out, you might mistakenly sew your up part at the down part. So you go ahead to leave it like that. Hope you get. Go ahead to leave it like that, please. Don't say I told you to cut it out. Or go ahead to leave it like that. So let me go ahead to arrange my front, because I want to cut out my armhole the way I did for you. Exactly the same. So for your back, if you want your back to be lower or higher, me, I want my back to be lower by 8 inches. The front is 9. The front is 7. I came down by 7 for my depth of my neck. So for the back now, I will take 8 for the depth. So all I need to do now is to connect this, my 8 now. Connect it down here. But as I told you, I'm not going to cut it out because for beginners, if I cut it out now, some might even use it to sew at the down part. So I'll leave my back like this. I'll use my front to cut out my back after sewing, but let me go ahead to cut the front for you to know that even when you sew, it will still come out okay. So you can see I've chopped it out. Chop it like moi moi out. Then for this side, chop it out. Always chop out. So I told you here will be straight when sewing like this. Chicken now, hope you see. Don't mind this one. Look at the shop here. There's something still left here for my shop. I hope you understand this. So this, we are okay for this. So we are done with our cutting for the of our off shoulder. So I don't know if I will show you how to pad it. I have a video on how to pad. In case you still want me to give you a detailed padding, just comment down below and I'll show you how to pad. As always, remain safe and stay blessed. God bless you all for watching. Thank you.